What is going on, guys? We are back playing some more Surviving with RotaryCraft. Now today, guys, we're going to be working on automating the production of ethanol crystals using this fermenter setup we have over here, which is going to get relocated eventually, along with a fully automated sugarcane farm and the recently constructed automated wood farm that we have out there. And all that's going to work together to make these ethanol crystals, which are going to be great for when we're using a performance engine, because now we're going to have as many ethanol crystals as we can get, and we also have pretty much unlimited blaze rods to get the blaze powder with, so performance engines will be all over the base eventually. But this is going to be a relatively long episode, at least I think it is, because there are a lot of steps that we need to do, and I'm going to divide this into kind of each step, and then we're going to cut and we'll go to another one. So this chest has a lot of what we're going to be working with in it today. We are going to need, obviously, some sugarcane. I have a lot of dirt in here because we actually do need to provide dirt when we're working with the fermenters. And then along with that, we've got all the stuff that's going to be required for the bud switch that we're going to be making, the bud switch sugarcane farm. And then along with that, transporting the items. And it's occurring to me now that I should probably dump some of this dirt in here just to make some extra room while we're doing the crafting. So we'll grab this out of here and grab that out, and it looks like we have a lonely steam engine in here that we don't have room for, but we will make room for that. So the first thing that we're going to be making is a sorting machine. We're going to be using this because the sugarcane farm is great in the fact that we're only getting sugarcane from that, and that is going to be able to be used in multiple different ways in this actual setup. But unfortunately, the wood farm that we have outside that's chopping down the trees is going to get us saplings, which we can use, sawdust, which we can use, but then unfortunately we can't use the wood, we can't use the apples. So we do want to sort those out into their own chest. So we're going to be making this. It's relatively simple to make. It's a hopper, two steel ingots, two base panels, and a circuit board, and you get the sorting machine. Now the sorting machine can be easily powered using a DC electric engine, and we're also going to be using the DC electric engines today for the pumps that we're going to need, and along with that, we're going to be using it for the, I believe it is the, let's see, I forget what it's called, the pneumatic item pump. Now this is great, and I'll explain why in a little bit when we start working with it, but we're going to be able to power our really long chain of these using just one DC electric engine. It's more than fast enough for that, so we should be able to craft it relatively easy. I'm going to make two sets, so we get 32 of these. It's just going to be six base panels per, an impeller, and two liquid pipes. So there we go. And I think for the most part, that should be all the crafting we're going to have to do today. Now, most of this is going to be set up outside, specifically because I want to be able to set it up relatively close to this farm over here. We need to make an automated sugarcane farm. And then along with that, I believe we're going to set up the fermenters outside and then pipe the sludge down into the basement where it's going to get cooked up into the ethanol crystals. So it is going to take a little bit of a journey as it's, you know, getting through its whole process, and I'm gonna have to chop down this tree right here to open up some space, but I think we should be able to construct this relatively close in terms of the sugarcane farm. It's not going to be a big sugarcane farm. I have 9 pistons. We're going to be using 8 spaces for sugarcane and then 1 piston for the bud switch. So that's the same case with the sand. 8 things of sugarcane, 1 for the bud switch. So I will cover all that, but you can expand it if you want to do a little bit more. I think we'll be okay with this for the time being, and I'll explain why when we start actually getting into what the fermenters are going to consume. But I think we can construct this right up here. The sugarcane farm should be good. Now, I did construct one of Mumbo Jumbo's sugarcane farms when I was playing in the Immersive Engineering Surviving With series, and that one was a little bit different than this one, and you'll see why in a little bit, but that one was, you know, used on a massive scale. This one is not used on a huge scale, and we don't need water for this one because we are going to be using the item vacuum, and this will be able to easily stretch. I believe it can stretch initially up to like 12 blocks, and we're only going to be doing 8 or 9, so we'll be fine with that. You can avoid using water altogether, so it makes this setup a lot easier. So to start out, I'm going to be placing down blocks. I think we can go all the way back here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's where the farm is going to be, and then we're going to be working a little bit over here with the redstone portion of it, but we're going to want to put down the sand right here, and I'm actually going to dig one behind this too, because we do need to have water down for this, so because I don't feel like, you know, having to deal with water being anywhere around here, I'm going to put it below this so that it stays hidden, and I can't even pick up that dirt right now. That's unfortunate, but okay, so just throw down the water down here, and place the sand down so we don't have to ever see it again. And there we go. So we got the 8 sand for this, and then like I said, we have 1 extra sand for the bud switch we're going to be making. And you can pretty much extend this as far as the redstone will go. pretty much, if you haven't seen a farm like this before, it's going to be when any one of these grows, the entire thing is going to extend and break it. And so unlike the last one I worked with, which was on a timer, this one is going to be updated based on when they grow. So next thing we're going to be doing is taking pistons and we're going to be placing them down facing the way the sugarcane goes, like so. And then we're going to be coming over to whichever side. You can do it on either one. I'm going to be doing it over here, and I am going to get the dirt out for this because we are going to be breaking this block eventually. But we're going to take, I should keep certain things in my hotbar right now. So we're going to get the redstone out, we're going to get a comparator out, all this good stuff. So we're going to put a piston down right like that. We're going to put a block of sand down above it, and then we're going to put a furnace down right over here. So there we go. Okay. So the furnace goes down there. Eventually we'll be putting items in that. And then we come over here and we got to kind of extend this out a little bit. And we're going to be putting a comparator down right there facing away from the sand that we just placed. And then we're going to be coming over, and I guess I should actually place down good blocks for this. So I'm going to break this comparator real quick. We do want to have good blocks because these are going to be staying right here. So the comparator goes down again and then come over, and we're going to be going up like this. And then we're going to be going, I think this should be correct. Yeah, so we're going to go up like that and run this one back along like this. So that should be good. And now we can get to place down all the redstone and verify that it works. So you're going to extend that all the way back. And then we're going to come over here and we're going to put down redstone right there. And then we're going to put down a repeater facing away from this block. And then we're going to put down redstone for the rest of this and just extend it all the way over. And then we just have to verify that it works, which we can easily do if we put just a stack of anything in here. We'll put some dirt in there. And, oh, dirt didn't go in there. There we go. Okay, so now we can try it out. There we go. So you can see the idea is going to be that it extends, drops the sand back down. That's why you use sand for this. And it'll reset and just pop it off. And we can do that all the way down to verify that it works. It extends all of them, like I said, and then it resets and they're ready to go again. So it is a really simple setup to do, really quick to do. And like I mentioned before, having an item vacuum does simplify this process a lot, because if we look at the description for an item vacuum, I believe it's under, is it under accessories? There we go. Okay, so it'll draw on items and XP orbs, blah, 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 blah. That's all, like, we already know that, it's pretty simple, but the idea is to look at the range. So the required power is going to easily come from a steam engine, which is great. And then if we look at the range, it's 8 plus, and then you take the power from a steam engine, multiply it by 4, and then divide it by that same number. So you're pretty much getting 8 plus, and then if you're giving it the required power, it should be 8 plus 4, assuming I'm, you know, not mixing anything up here. So it should go 12 blocks if it's at the minimum power, and of course you can go further than that. But like I said, since we're only doing it with 8 here, we're not going to need to worry about that. I actually did want to make sure it was far enough away from what's going on over there that if anything does drop from that and doesn't get sucked up, that it doesn't bring itself over here and screw up the sorting. So we can throw down the item vacuum. I guess we can do it right here. It may depend on how you want to set it up based on if you're going to be doing more than just one row of this. We can set it up right here, and I can break this dirt block down here. Yep, you can see it updates just because we broke that. And then we can do the typical setup with the steam engine. And unfortunately, it just occurred to me that I forgot to get some netherrack. But we can throw the steam engine down there, and I should swap all this stuff off my hotbar again and get the correct stuff out. So we need the electric engine, shaft junction, and we need the pump and the liquid pipes. Okay, so flip this around, liquid pipe there, and then we can just face this over on this side. It's going to be a little crude, but we can do pump right there and rotate that. And then I don't have my shovel on me, of course. Okay, so we can dig down here, do the shaft junction, and get the DC electric engines going. And it also occurred to me that I don't have redstone for the DC electric engines, so I will have to get that too. So shaft junction is going to go right there and rotate that like this. I think this should be okay. Yeah, I think that should be okay. So then rotate these. I don't think this will interfere if there's redstone right there. I hope it doesn't. I will go inside and grab the stuff that we need for levers and the netherrack. Okay, so netherrack, stuff we need for levers. Here we go. Okay. So we'll make a fair bit just because we do have a lot of DC electric engines we're going to be working with today. And let's hope that this redstone doesn't screw that up. It's becoming nighttime too, so if we could finish this up, that'd be great. Okay, so that doesn't interfere at all. I'm just going to check this. I'm not great when it comes to redstone in terms of the diagonal movement of it, but okay, I'm going to flip these off now just so I can fill in and refill my buckets without having to worry. So we can fill this in. I can dig out right back here and fill up both my buckets from that and then refill this and flip it back on. So it starts filling that up with water, and then we can light it on fire below it and let that thing run, and that should start collecting all the sugar cane that we're going to need. So light this on fire down here, get out our netherrack and our flint and steel. Okay, so there we go, got that all set up. So that should be good. That should be collecting all the sugar cane that we're going to need, and then we can easily pump it out of this item vacuum using these pneumatic item pumps. So I am going to hop off camera now. We're going to make it daytime. I'm going to get everything set so that we can start pumping from both of these into the fermenter setup, and I will get that situated. I think I might need to level the ground a little bit over here to actually start doing that, but I will do that and then we'll hop back and start working on it. Okay guys, so we are back. It is now daytime and we should be good to go with setting up the fermenters and starting to bring everything over into them. But I would consider this to be the more interesting part, but also slightly more annoying, because bringing everything together in such a confined space might be slightly difficult. So, you know, I had issues working with it in the house. Hopefully being outside will make it a little bit easier. Now, I did start moving some of the stuff. I already moved this pump setup and I have it running solely because I've set this up so many times. I'd like to at least limit myself to doing it, you know, once per video, you know, in case we have some newbies joining us. But we already have this set up. This should be enough water being pumped into our two fermenters to allow them to run. Now, the reason that this is nice having this as a slightly lower level is because it does drop down a lot as we're working with it. So the way I had them set up before was to have, I guess this is a relatively even spot right here. I would have the first fermenter set up right up here, and then the second one would be down here, and you would just, oh gosh, okay, that's going to keep happening every time. I'll leave the sugarcane in there, take everything else out, but we would have a hopper below it, and those are right here. And that would just bring from the yeast from this one down into this one right here. Now, I did have a couple issues with the redstone. I believe initially people had suggested that I put it below this, and I believe that causes an issue when you're using this hopper right here, allowing things to go in here, which if I were to break this, I don't think that would be the case. Is it? Okay. Well, maybe I'm just losing my mind right now, but people had suggested I put it down here, and as you know, the redstone will switch from making yeast to making sludge, which is great, but we do need to first off get DC electric engines on both of these, because they do require a minuscule amount of power, but it is power, to say the least. So we can flip both of those on, and I did it like this last time again because of the redstone interactions we're going to be getting, and I probably should use stone brick for this, so we're going to throw it like this. Get both of these powered, so they should be good to go. We've already discussed the temperature stuff before and how you want to make sure that they're in the green level, and that when it becomes nighttime, they will switch a little bit. They can switch depending on what's going on around them, biomes, everything like that. So now what we need to talk about is getting the water into them and how I want to pump the other items in. So for the time being, I'm going to put the water in them like this. I might need to raise this up one more when it comes to piping items into either this fermenter or this fermenter, but what should happen is we're able to put dirt in the bottom here, and the sugarcane will also go into this one, so I should be able to pump it pretty much straight from that over to this. And then with this one, we should be able to put saplings in there, and if I put it in this, it doesn't want to go over, but if I break this, it also doesn't want to go over. I'm realizing now, because this is going to yeast, but if I put a redstone torch there, it should want to go over. Now, one thing people had told me was to break this block, I believe, and try it again, because it should not have redstone interaction, so we can always try it again. See, that doesn't work still, unfortunately, so I don't know if it's something else that's causing that issue, but it seems to be that block right there. So I'm just letting people know, because I know last time I commented on placing the redstone and where to place it, because this doesn't look the best, and people were like, oh, just put it under there and break that block. Don't worry guys, I did think of that, and I believe that's actually where we're gonna pull all of the sludge out from. So now we need to start pumping stuff in. So over here, we need to get the sugarcane out of this, and we're gonna be using the pneumatic item pumps for that. So we can easily just go like this and flip it around. So you can see it does have a nice arrow on it and it's pointing in this direction. So I guess we can go like this and we can draw it out. Now, unfortunately for some reason, I didn't think that I should move this one forward a little bit. Oop, that one just functioned there, so it should be at 54. Nice. So I didn't think to kind of maneuver this so that it would go straight into this right here, but I think we should be able to work around that a little bit. So I think if we go like this, it should work still. And then if we go like this, and then we can continue extending it. So you can see that this does kind of blend together when it's going in a single direction. Now, I did test this out a little bit, and it seems like you can flip directions as long as they stay in contact. So this will push it into this inventory, into this one, and then it'll keep going. Now, we can power these using a single DC electric engine, and it's awesome because you can hook the engine up anywhere you want. So for me, I guess we can hook it up right over here because we have a lot less going on. We can flip it around and we can throw it down. And I believe that should bring all of this stuff over here, assuming that I did it correctly. Okay guys, so we are back. A lot has happened off camera that I'm going to explain to you guys, but this whole setup does work perfectly, so we should be good to go once I finish getting through all this. So first things first, it starts off pulling out of the item vacuum. I did take the sugarcane out for now so that I can show you guys the whole process as it's running. But then we have the pneumatic item pump putting everything into a hopper. We do have the DC electric engine running solely for this one right now. The hopper has some dirt in it, but this should just be transporting the sugarcane into the auto crafting unit. For some reason, when I put down the pneumatic item pump directly next to the auto crafting unit, it wasn't inserting it correctly, but it seems to work with a hopper, so maybe that's just something I'm doing wrong. But now I want to cover the auto crafting unit in general. So I did make this off camera, which is a little bit unusual for me, but the auto crafting unit, relatively simple, just a crafting table, 4 steel ingots, 3 base panels, and a circuit board, and it allows for a bunch of auto crafting, up to 18 patterns, and you can have a couple different modes where you can request stuff, have it be continuous, have it save some for you. You can power it using a DC electric engine, and we have it in the continuous mode right now, which means anything that gets inserted into it is going to immediately have the recipe occur, and then it's going to output it. So that is where this crafting pattern comes into use. Now the crafting pattern is relatively easy to make, inexpensive, which is great. I gotta specify a little bit more so that we can see it, but the crafting pattern is right here. You get multiple using just 2 steel ingots and a base panel. I only needed one, but this is great if you're using this for multiple things. So you're going to get this, and then you're going to right click with it, and you can switch between a couple different things. It'll give you blank spaces for you to work with. So you got the work table recipe, blast furnace crafting, and the regular one. We're just going to use regular and go for sugarcane to sugar. So hovering over it right now crafts 1 sugar, and it's in the crafting recipe. So once we finish with that, it should be all good to go, and we can slap it into the auto crafting unit. Now, one thing to keep in mind is when you place this auto crafting unit down, this right up here is going to be red. I guess I can break it just to show you guys. So when we place it back down right here, this is red. So this is the request one, which means when we put a recipe in there, we can hit one of these and request it. But if we were to shift right click using the screwdriver, it will change it to continuous, which is what we want. So if you hold shift, you can also see the output. And so now everything should be running smoothly. We can throw in all of these and they should get easily converted and pop into here relatively quickly as sugar. So there should be no issue with that. I did have a couple in my inventory just because I was testing this out. And then all we need to do is throw some dirt in here, which is why I have a hopper on top of this and a chest. So there might be a little bit of an easier way to get dirt in there, but dirt is going to be used with the sugar to make the yeast. If we look at the recipe for this, that is the recipe. There is no getting around it. It's a little odd that it shows 51 yeast right there because that's the amount that I have, but you're pretty much going to use water and sugar to make the yeast. So are you going to use water, sugar, and dirt to make the yeast? So I have a bunch of dirt. Most people will. So you can just stockpile it in this chest, and you probably won't run out anytime soon. You can see that this, because it's nighttime, is really low on temperature, so this is going to be relatively slow. So what I'm going to do is go inside. We can sleep. We can grab a good amount of dirt that we can throw into this. This chest gets relatively full, especially because I was doing that huge clearing out of this area while I was working. And yeah, you can see I'm really bad about updating stuff, unfortunately. So I do need to go and update to 15A, I believe it said. But we can throw this dirt in there now, and we can finish things off by pumping in the rest of the sawdust and the saplings. So I'll just throw the rest of this dirt in here. This should cover us for a very, very long time. And you can see it is running relatively quick now because the temperature is back up. Everything should be making its way into here. So we got the yeast going in there. Nothing's getting stalled in there. That is great. Is that Okay, so that is going in there. We can throw the yeast that we already have in there. And now we're looking to make sludge. So we go over here and let's look at all the different ways to make sludge to go over what we're going to be doing. So I did cover this last episode, but there are a lot of different recipes to make sludge, including all the different types of saplings, which will get you one. We can use sawdust. We can use potatoes. We can use sugarcane, lily pads. And then you get into the leaves, which do get you one more sludge per yeast. But we can also use the shrubs, dandelions, flowers, vines, all that good stuff. So we're going to be using sawdust and saplings for the most part. Typically, people would probably set up a really large sugarcane farm and just feed the sugar into one side, split it in half, and then feed the rest of the sugarcane into the fermenter. But because we have this right over here, I thought, hey, why not? So that's what we're going to be doing. Now, I did mention that we do need to sort this using the sorting machine earlier, so that's what we're going to be doing. I actually think we might need another DC electric engine eventually for this, because I do need to power this two different ways. So first off, we can just come in below here, and we're gonna have to pull the stuff out of this chest. So I'm trying to think of the best way to do this. I think we're gonna want to come out this side and wrap around like we did before. So we can throw this down here and just rotate it until it's facing out the way we want. There we go. And I think we should be able to face it this direction now. And let me get out my shovel real quick. So we're gonna want to face it over here, and then we'll eventually sort it with a chest. So face it like this, and that all lines up nicely. And we're gonna want to get it in line as best we can right over here to make it a smooth run over, and then probably up into this machine. I think we can either go in the front and then pull out the bottom, which, yeah, actually I think that's what we're gonna want to do. So we're gonna want to input this into the front here, so eventually we're gonna want the stuff to be output right here to run it over. Now we need to throw down the sorting machine. So sorting machine is interesting in that there are some specific things that you have to do when it comes to the sides. So we're going to want to be inputting it in the top. So I'm actually going to break this and bring it down one. As far as I'm aware, we're going to want to input in the top. I have not heard anything otherwise, which is why I did have a hopper. So I couldn't be mistaken. We actually, you know what we could do to make this a little bit easier? Instead of using a hopper, we should be able to rotate most of the pneumatic item pumps around to get it in the top here. So if I were to put the sorting machine, let's say right here, we should be able to finagle with this and get it in the correct side. Now we do have to rotate this because you can see we've got the blue, we got the red, we've got the green, and then we've got one side that's got nothing on it. So that side is where the power is going to be going, and we're going to want that to be right there. Okay, so this is the side we want. We're going to be powering this with a DC electric engine. Tons of DC electric engines today. And you can see you can set all the different things you want to get sorted in here. So one side that's going to be really easy to sort is going to be the side right here. So red side is going to be where we want the wood to go, and we want the apples to go. Stuff that we're not going to be using right away. And it is a little bit difficult to access this. I am going to break this so we're not getting any trees growing while we're working. And I'm going to grab out one piece of wood. Gonna grab out a sapling, sawdust, and an apple. So all the different things that we can get from this setup. The sawdust is a lot more common. That's probably what'll be running through our system for the most part. And I might eventually just say we only want to use sawdust and not saplings if I run into an issue. But we're gonna say that we want the apples to go out red, and we want the oak wood to go out red. And then we're gonna be pulling out blue, the saplings, and the sawdust. So these can all get thrown right back in here. And there we go. I think that should be everything. So we have that. Now it'll be sorted when it comes over here, and we need to pull it out of this side right here. So this might be a little bit awkward with how we do this. I'm trying to think of how I want to pull this out necessarily, because we want to have it. I don't know if this automatically ejects into this inventory. We can always try it like this and see if it works, because if it is able to automatically eject into this pneumatic item pump right here, then that'll be great. Where did that disappear to? Did I just pick that back up? I have no idea. But we'll throw down the DC electric engine right... we'll throw it over here just because I want to make sure we have enough room. So this DC electric engine is going to get powered. Rotate that. I think... Oh, no. 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 Why did that just start spewing stuff out so much? Okay, I'm a little bit confused. It might be because we didn't line this stuff up correctly. Is it below this? Did I ever line it up? Oh, I didn't actually connect these. Oh my gosh. Okay, so you guys can see the downside of using this. If you don't hook it up right, it spews this stuff all over the place. So let's try and actually get this hooked up correctly before we do anything else. Yeah, so there's nothing under there that's actually going to be working. I don't think we can input it in the bottom. I think let's try. We can always try. It can't hurt. So let's try inputting it in the bottom. And we can see how that goes. So there's nothing left in this chest, but let's throw the oak wood in there. Does it come spewing out? No. Does it pull it out of this at all? No. Okay, so I don't think we can do that. I don't think we can insert it at the bottom there. We can always try pushing it. Oh, that's phenomenal. That's just great. Okay, so we can always try putting it in the top of this. It is a little awkward, like I said, getting this to actually work correctly. In terms of rotating it, I've had it work successfully sometimes, not work sometimes. So typically it'd be like this and like this. I may have to go off camera to get this to actually work, but I think that should work then. Is this still, that's still running. So if we were to throw 32 wood in there, would it come out over here? Would it come out if I did a hopper? I think that's actually what I normally do. We're gonna want to turn this off then. Oh no. Okay, we're gonna turn that off. We're gonna break this. We're gonna throw down a hopper right here. And then we're gonna flip it back on and we're gonna see if that works. There we go. We did it, boys. We did it. Okay, everything should be working now. That should all go into that chest there. So we should be able to throw all this stuff. Does the wood... Okay, so that gets spewed out over here. Yeah, that gets dumped out over there. So we're gonna wanna make sure we only are throwing in the stuff that's gonna stay in there, which is gonna be the regular wood and the apples. But hopefully I can clean most of this up before it despawns over here. Man, this thing shoots it far. Damn. That's really far distance for that. Okay, well, collect what I can. I'm not really worried about losing some of this. But now we have that taken care of. We don't have to deal with that anymore. Now we're just dealing with this side over here. So we don't need to send any of that through. We can just dump this directly back in here. And now it comes to sorting with this side. So I can't tell if this was spewing it out over here because it didn't want to actually send it out or because we don't have this powered. But I might need to loop this around a little bit. What I'm thinking we're going to do is like this, though. We're going to go over here and then we're going to send it right in the front like that. So I do need to go get a little bit more stuff. I'll work with this off camera to get it to work and then we will hop back and we will get to see the system in full glory. Okay guys, so we are back. Everything should be good to go now. I did have to do a lot of messing around to get this actually to work, and I did always have an issue with this corner junction right here, but it seems like throwing a hopper down allows it to work relatively easily. I'm not sure why I was having trouble with it over here using the same setup I did over here, but you know what? I just gave up. It takes one more DC electric engine. If I ever figure it out, I'll replace it, but for the time being, it's perfectly fine. So everything makes its way over to the fermenter, and I do still have a lot of this stuff in my inventory. So what I'm going to do now is throw it all in there and make sure that it's going to work. Or if we need to throw a hopper down over here just to create kind of like a backstop for it. So let's throw in a bunch of sawdust and allow that to go over. And it does slowly make its way in there. Is that stuff? So it does, it spits it out, some of it, and then some of it makes its way in there because it looks like it's going too fast for this. So I would have to get that to work, but it does fill this up. So typically, this would be no issue, actually, getting this all set up correctly. The problem comes from me throwing, like, stacks upon stacks in there. So once I get this backup worked out, this should function perfectly. All I need to do is put down the wood right in front of this, or put down the dirt in front of this again and replant a sapling when I'm ready to go. But I'm going to let it stop for the time being and catch up with all the stuff that I have in here. So the rest of this wood can get thrown in there, the apples, and I will slowly work my way through all these saplings. But this is the system. Everything is working perfectly. We're getting sludge produced out of this. And eventually, I'm not going to do it on camera now, but I will just run this down to, I'll run it through either item pumps, hoppers, anything like that, all the way down to the furnace in the basement that is automatically powered using the frictional heater, and we will get ethanol crystals produced in a chest down there. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the episode. If you found it informative or entertaining in any way, please feel free to give it a like. Sorry that I did have to bumble around a little bit getting things set up, but I actually didn't test this whole thing out in my creative world because I know a lot of you said you'd prefer longer episodes where I don't, you know, just blast through everything. So you got to see my thought process a little. Let me know what you guys think about that, and I will talk to you guys later.